My name is Michelle Richter. I've been a member at Transform CrossFit here in Pennington for about a year and a half now. And I have four daughters and a husband. I live nearby in Princeton, New Jersey. And I'm so excited to be a part of CrossFit for Hope with our affiliate. I don't think there could be a better match than CrossFit and raising money for childhood cancer research. At my 20-week ultrasound, when I was pregnant with my oldest daughter, Rachel, she was diagnosed with a large lung tumor called a CCAM, a congenital cystic adenoid malformation. That's over 9 years ago now. To say the least, it was devastating to get that diagnosis, but we had amazing doctors. She was seen by fetal surgeons at Children's Hospital in Philadelphia. And she faced fetal surgery while we were pregnant. She faced immediate surgery after she was born. The good news is we kind of best case scenarioed through the entire process, and she was able to have her surgery to remove this large lung tumor when she was 2 months old. Again, we were very fortunate in we had a diagnosis of a benign tumor. Needless to say, though, I spent so much time at the Children's Hospital meeting lots of families that were faced with much more serious illnesses than what my daughter was. And it really broke my heart to know that some of these parents weren't bringing their kids home from the hospital. In fact, over the years, I became friends with someone who lost his son to pediatric brain cancer. And what the family went through is just mind-numbing as to the pain and suffering to watch this beautiful, talented, creative young boy lose his life after such a valiant struggle with this disease. So I am so extremely proud and honored to be a part of this fundraising effort here at Transform CrossFit and CrossFit for Hope worldwide. Kids that wouldn't have survived a few years ago are now having longer survival rates. It struck me that there could be no greater gift than to have a parent or a family wake up with their child on Christmas morning rather than face the alternative. So I decided for Christmas this year that I didn't want anything. My Christmas list had one thing on it: help me raise money to help cancer research for kids. And Christmas morning came, you know, the kids tugged us all downstairs. We ran down at 6 a.m. I didn't realize my husband had gone down the night before and stuck cards in everybody's stocking. When I opened mine, I was really floored by what he had done. It was a pretty generous donation for childhood cancer research. He had also slipped $100 bills in all of my girls' stockings, and they were completely floored by a $100 bill because they're young children, 9 years and younger. And when they saw me crying because I was so touched by what my husband had helped me do, they gathered around me and they were concerned. They wondered what happened? Why is mommy crying? I assured them that they were just tears of joy for what we were able to do. And they all grabbed their $100 bills and forced their $100 bills on me to help the children with cancer too. So I think sharing a story like that and getting involved on a personal level with your family and children, if you have them, is very helpful. And when I sent out my email to folks that I know who might be interested in helping support this cause this time around, I shared not only Rachel's story and our struggle with her tumor and surgery, but I also shared the story of Christmas time. And I had many emails back commenting on the personal nature of the email and the story. And I think that really is what helped to get people involved in supporting this cause during this particular fundraising event. I've said to people many times, until every parent hears the words, "Your child will be okay, you can take him or her home," there's just so much more that we can do.